Is easily one of the most powerful beings in the Marvel Universe, and though he has a great deal of strength and power of his own, he's best known for lugging around a magical hammer called Mjolnir, or as Josh likes to call, Meow Meow. Over the years, Mjolnir has been interpreted differently by different writers, and as this occurred, different versions of the hammer were introduced into Marvel's mythology. And while Thor's weapons are significantly more powerful than most anything found throughout the Marvel Universe, some are certainly better than others. So, seeing as how I'm looking for coping mechanisms with Jason Aaron's run on Thor coming to a close, oh god, the pain, I'm Ewan, this is What Culture Comics, and here's all of Thor's hammers ranked from worst to best. Number 13, Marvel Zombies Hammer. Marvel Zombies gave true believers zombified versions of their favorite characters, and Thor wasn't immune to the plague that took all of Earth's mightiest heroes in this particular universe. Sadly, a zombified version of Thor couldn't lift Mjolnir. Something about feasting on the flesh of the living made him slightly less Thor-worthy than his less dead counterparts. For this reason, Thor opted to use another hammer that didn't restrict its use to a more fair-minded Thor. To this end, the Odin son found himself a hammer that looked much like his beloved Mjolnir, but had none of the magical enchantments that make it a killer weapon. Now, to be fair, Thor could just use a regular hammer from the hardware store to deadly effect, but it still wouldn't come close in comparison to the real thing. Number 12, Earth 37072, the Medieval Hammer. In yet another multiverse, the Marvel Universe is stuck in the Middle Ages. In this reality, the world is controlled by a being who calls himself Kulan Gath, and not wanting to fail in impressing his visitors, he puts the mighty Thor in as one of his guards. This version of Thor looks a lot like a Viking instead of his usual Asgardian look from the comics. He carried a hammer named Mjolnir, which looks different from his Earth 616 hammer. This version of Mjolnir has a spherical head instead of the more angular version we're most familiar with. In the comics, it functioned pretty much like the normal Mjolnir, but was clearly not as powerful. Number 11, Thunderstrike. There was a time when Thor was replaced by this guy whom Odin had given a powerful mace called Thunderstrike. Look, we have a saying here at What Culture Comics, and that's that we can't judge what happened in the 90s, no matter how leathery, pouchy, mullety, or spiky they were. Anyway, Masterson went on to call himself the same name of his weapon, and while it isn't exactly a hammer, Thunderstrike qualifies for the list due to the similarities between the two weapons. The inscription on the weapon reads, "The world still needs heroes, and it is made from Uru, the same metal as the mightiest Asgardian weapons and armor." The head of the weapon is more angular than a traditional hammer, and its handle had a strap on the end too. Number 10, Ragnarok's Hammer. In the main continuity of Earth 616, Thor died, as many comic characters do from time to time, but he was replaced with the help of Tony Stark, Reed Richards, and Hank Pym. The three scientists slash madmen thought it would be a good idea to clone a god, and as one might expect, it didn't work out well for the rest of the Marvel Universe. The Thor clones stormed onto the scene with a special hammer created by three men, since the clone's worthiness was still somewhat in question. He went to battle and immediately killed Goliath by shooting a blast of lightning through his chest, so yeah, this one didn't work out too well. Number 9, the Earth 1610 Ultimate Hammer. In the Ultimate Universe, Mjolnir was created by Odin instead of the dwarves. It was crafted with a piece of Asgard embedded within, and it gave it a specific purpose. The main purpose of the hammer was to help Asgard be reborn following Ragnarok, and the piece of Asgard was the main component of accomplishing that. This version of Mjolnir doesn't come with a worthiness clause either, and anyone who can pick up a hammer can pick it up. When this happens, it imparts the power of Thor onto its wielder, and it didn't sacrifice anything in granting those abilities to whoever held it. Number 8, Tyrene's Golden Hammer. When Thor saved a young woman from Thanos, she became determined to emulate her hero by calling herself Thorgirl. Thorgirl, or Tyrene, was destined to become a cosmic being known as the Designate, who was prophesied to evolve life throughout the universe, but before that could happen, she gave superhero work a try. In emulating her hero, she created a hammer for herself. The hammer is covered in pure gold, but that's only to make it look good. It's an incredibly powerful hammer, but is somewhat smaller in size when compared to Mjolnir. Because of her divine prophecy, she managed to create a power with all the same magical enchantments as Thor's favorite weapon. But with great power comes an eventual loss of great power, if Marvel Comics has anything to say about it, because when Odin died, her limitless cosmic power died as well. Either way, her hammer was never given a name in the comics, and as a result, it's usually referred to as Tyrene's or Thorgirl's hammer. Number 7, Crusher. Roger Red Norvell was just a cameraman sent to Asgard to create a television documentary, but thanks to the machinations of Loki, he became something more. He quickly became smitten with Lady Sif, as one generally does, and this got Loki to convince Red to don Meginjord, Thor's belt of strength. He was then compelled to reach into the fire of Gerador to get the gloves of power. When both of these items were combined, they gave Red the power of Thor, and he was able to lift Mjolnir. And then he was dead, within 5 issues. Okay. It was all a ploy by Odin to use Loki to basically trick the Fates into killing Thor, but not the Thor. Having felt somewhat crummy about casting Red in his ploy to trick the Fates, he resurrected him a good 200 issues later. He couldn't give him Mjolnir since it wasn't his at the time to give, so he instead gave him a hammer called Crusher. And it looks really, really cool. Crusher is a double-handed warhammer, which is far more powerful than a standard issue 16-ounce hammer you pick up to defend yourself from duels when there's a full moon out in the sky. Number 6, Earth 14325, Thor's Hammer. Similar to how Bizarro is the opposite of Superman, Thor, or Thor because I can't keep making that noise without buckling at the sight of it, is the opposite of Thor. Initially hailing from Earth 14325, Thor was brought to Earth 616 by AIM, with the goal of defeating the Avengers. Thor was a member of the Tyrant Avengers, and his hammer differed a bit from Mjolnir. The inscription on his hammer read as follows: "Whosoever holds this hammer, if he be unworthy, shall possess the power of Thor." Adding that extra R to the name turned Thor into an evil badass, but he and his evil associates were eventually defeated by the Avengers. Other than the opposing worthiness enchantment, Thor's hammer wasn't much different to Thor's Mjolnir. This proved to be helpful when Thor lost his worthiness following Original Sin, and could no longer carry his weapon. He would carry Thor's due to his unworthiness, and did so in New Avengers number 27, in one of my favorite comic moments ever. The new hammer came with some dark and twisted aspects, leading the God of Thunder to don some new clothes too. But despite being an incredibly powerful version of Mjolnir, it isn't more powerful than the original. Number 5. Throg, the Frog of Thunder's Mjolnir. Yes, there was a time when Thor was a frog, but it isn't as silly as it sounds. Okay, it's definitely as silly as it sounds, but it turns out the worthiness enchantment isn't strictly limited to humanoids. When Loki turned Thor into a frog, he needed help, which led him to a little amphibian named Puddlegulp. With Puddlegulp's help, Thor was able to fight off an army of rats, which saved the community of frogs and returned Thor to his normal size. After he left, a small shaving of Uru fell from Mjolnir to the ground. When Puddlegulp saw this, he hopped over and picked it up, instantly transforming into Throg, the Frog of Thunder. He became the rightful protector of New York Central Park, and he ensured the safety of his fellow frogs with his own little hammer, which has been dubbed Frogjolnir. Comics really don't get any better, do they? Number 4. Mjolnir. Mjolnir first appeared alongside Thor in Journey into Mystery, and both have had a major impact throughout the Marvel Universe ever since. It has been wielded by Thor Odinson, but it has also been picked up by several other characters deemed worthy enough to wield it. The hammer can empower a normal person with the power of Thor, which is what it did initially, though it would transform into a walking stick and reverse the transformation if it wasn't held for a short period of time. Over the years, it has changed in appearance and level of power, but one thing is certain: it's an incredibly powerful and brilliant weapon. God bless you, Jack Kirby. Number 3. Earth 10190, Mjolnir. While the Asgardians are considerably important in any reality, they were especially big deals in Earth 10190. The reality was inadvertently created by Loki, which resulted in a far more savage race of Asgardians than your garden variety Earth 616 model. The most powerful Asgardian in this reality was none other than Thor himself, but unlike his typical counterpart, he was a brutal and bloodthirsty psychopath. The Earth 10190 Mjolnir was covered with spikes, and seeing as the universe pretty much revolved around Asgard and Thor himself, it was the most powerful weapon in the entire universe. In a pound-per-pound fight against the normal version of Mjolnir, this spiky one takes the lead simply because the spikes make it look much cooler than the original. Number 2. The Hammer of Thorion. Back in the 1990s, Marvel and DC put aside their differences to show the world how closely related their IPs actually were. The two publishing houses created an imprint called Amalgam Comics with the goal of combining their most popular characters into single beings. Thor found himself paired up with the new god Orion from the DC universe to become Thorion of the New Gods. He only ever appeared once, as most Amalgam characters did, but he held a mighty weapon. In the story, Thorion was locked in a perpetual battle of dominance with his father, Thanoside, and Loki. He carried a hammer, which featured a shorter handle and leather strap, but it was far more powerful than the typical Mjolnir of the Marvel Universe since it had to provide enough power to boost whoever wielded it to both Thor and Orion levels of mightiness. And number 1, Stormbreaker. The Stormbreaker from the comics is different than the one seen in the MCU, and if you thought the one Thor wielded in the movies was powerful, you ain't seen nothing yet. Stormbreaker was created by Odin for the explicit purpose of granting the power of Thor to Beta Ray Bill. When he was first introduced, Thor and Beta Ray Bill got into a tussle over a misunderstanding, but it was immediately apparent that he was worthy of carrying Mjolnir, and Odin recognized this by going to the best dwarven blacksmith around, Ytri of Nidavellir. Stormbreaker was imbued with the same Asgardian powers as Mjolnir, and by wielding it, Beta Ray Bill was given the power of Thor. It does differ in one way that actually makes it slightly better than the real thing. It is entirely crafted from Uru, instead of just the hammerhead. This, paired with a worthiness charm and the ability to create portals into other dimensions, make the hammer a bit better than the one that inspired its creation. Also, Bill? Class! Look at him, the crazy old alien horse.